All right, boys, welcome to the new episode of Breaking It Down with Y and K. This one will be a bit different. I'm going to try and break down the whole game in this one, round by round. And this is the match between Luminosity and Avi. As you can see, it's from DreamHack Leipzig, the grand finals. It was an amazing game. And personally, for me, these are the two, you know, my two favorite teams to watch, the favorite matchup for me right now in CSGO, simply because both teams have great individual players, but they also have a great understanding of CS, and they're good tactical teams as well. So let's go straight into it. Navi is on the T side, Luminosity is on the CT side. Like, Navi usually on their T sides, they go pretty straightforwardly, go towards the B side, which they opt to do in this round, in this match as well. As you can see, they only have a Molotov and a Flash, and they're just gonna, you know, brute force their way in, trying to plant the bomb and then get closer to the T. And you can see right now that Edward is the most important player here, because he's the one who got into that forward position. That's what you want to do. With the USPs, they have the advantage long range, obviously. So in the pistol rounds, optimally, you would like to get into those close range battles as T, where you have the upper hand. Sizzt is watching the flank, Guardian is planting the bomb, and Zeus is staying back, maybe trying to draw some attention so that Edward can do his thing. And as you will see in just a moment, Edward makes a great play for his team. He pushes forward, gets a kill on FNX, gets another kill on Taco, then finishes off Cold Zero as well, securing the pistol round for Navi. And now in the second round, LG decide to, I don't think they forced here, or they did force. We can see that they did force. So first through the scout for Fallen, so that Fallen could still buy an AWP in the first gun round. And this is going to be a pretty straight forward round for Navi. We can see that they decide to go for a default, wait things out a little bit. Sizzt actually throws a smoke from T-spawn all the way towards the link here, probably to draw some rotations from the CTs. They throw another smoke close on the lower ramp near the train, but Taco is close here, so he gets the info that there's no one going B, actually that it's a fake. So right now you're gonna see Fur rotating as well, but they get the entry kill on FNX. Cold Zero is pushing behind them, but Zeus is watching the flank. Navi gets all the kills here, and it's a pretty straightforward round for them. Cold Zero managed to save a Galil. He got a kill and got a Galil, and that's it. Another eco round for Luminosity. Cold tries to make something happen with a Galil early, because, I mean, he's not gonna be able to do anything by just standing somewhere passively. He goes for a play to maybe give his team an early advantage. That doesn't work out for him. Navi, again, doing a slow, methodical anti-eco round, knowing that the other players from Luminosity don't have any armor. So Luminosity decides to gamble and stack B-side, because if you don't have armor, you only have a couple of pistols, you're not gonna win a round, or maybe not even get a kill if you just go for some standard setup. So they go for the gamble, hoping that Navi would go B. Doesn't work out for them. Again, Navi is going to clean up here pretty soon. So we can see that FNX gets one kill, and in the end, I don't think Fur is going to save a gun either. He's just gonna survive. So now we have the good stuff. Now we come to the first gun round. As you can see, Fallen has the AWP, but the rest of the players, because they forced in the second round, look at their equipment. They don't have, like, they have only three smokes, a flash, and a grenade, while Navi has pretty much all of their stuff, Guardian with the AWP as well. So at this point, considering that you're CT on train, you gotta go for some play, you gotta make something happen. And LG being a strong strategic team as well. They are aware of this. And maybe even, watching demos of Na'Vi, anti-threading them a little bit, figuring out what their default is, how they like to run their default, they go for this play. So they push Fallen towards Ivy to go for the entry kill. You can see these green circles, there are grenades. I think that Na'Vi even expects this, because you can see them throwing two grenades and a flash. But the thing is, Fallen will take damage, but he will, not get flashed. Cold throws a counter flash as well. So, but this time, the nades and the flashes that Na'Vi used didn't gain them any ground. They're still not here close enough to get the kill on Fallen. So they're still way back, which will allow Fallen, as you can see, he decides to go for the push. He wins the dual kill with Guardian. Great flash and great flash from Cold, great movement from Fallen to go behind the box here or whatever, and get another kill, and instantly giving a two-man advantage for his team. And now Na'Vi is in trouble. Edward is pretty much forced to try and do something here by himself. He'll get one kill, but instantly get traded, and LG are going to close out the round here pretty straightforward for them. CZ is going to save the AWP in the end for the next round. So this is also a very important round for LG, because the most important thing in one of the most important factors in CS is not just winning one round. When you lost consecutive rounds, is you have to win consecutive rounds. Then otherwise, if you just win one round, lose the following round, your money is going to be reset, your economy situation is going to be reset, and you're going to have to maybe even double eco after that. Na'Vi has, of course, enough money to buy in this round, but if they lose this round, they're going to have to eco too. So this is a pretty crucial round for both teams. And now we're going to see what Luminosity decides to do in an important round like this. Na'Vi goes for the pretty much the straight default as before, but LG switches things up. They just throw a smoke immediately towards Ivy. And remember that they threw smoke in this round, because it's going to be important soon in the following round. Fallen decides to, go for some peek somewhere else, and they were maybe even expecting an outer rush from Na'Vi, so they had four players outside. Although that's pretty standard, going with four players outside on your CT setup. So Na'Vi is going again for their slow default towards Ivy. Edward is holding team mid, and Zeus is holding the ladder area if someone tries to push B, pretty much. And Fallen is in a pretty aggressive position here. Him and FNX as well, they're smoking off ladder so they can stay in that position. You will notice that Fallen was the one who threw the first smoke here. So now Na'Vi is trying to put some pressure with a smoke, but that doesn't work because Cold just returns the smoke. Things are slowing down a bit. CZ is left alone in Ivy, which is where he almost always goes. Na'Vi wants to go for an outer 1-3-1 split, but Fallen gets the kill on Flamie here. Now CZ pushes here. Edward gets one kill, but will get traded by Cold, FNX as well. They're just cleaning up house here, because Na'Vi were, at this point, when they went for the execute, they didn't have a lot of resources. They had two smokes and three flashes basically to throw, and Edward didn't throw, I think, anything here. So they were basically trying to get the trades. Luminosity managed to win the aim duels, and they managed to win the really important round here. So moving forward, as you can see now, Na'Vi is forced to eco, and they again, you can see that Cold went aggressively towards Ivy to get some information straight away. You can see that Na'Vi has two smokes, two flashes. They're gonna go for the, B attack with smokes and flashes, trying to get the bomb down. But after Cold got this information, Luminosity already has three players towards inner. So as this execute comes in. Basically, Cole is already flanking. He got one kill on Zeus, who was way back. So Navi are now just waiting a bit, maybe trying to get a free kill here and there if Cole overextends. So they finally go for that inner push with smokes, but they only get the one kill on Guardian. Seized wanted to try and plant outside, gets the kill on Cold, but FNX shuts him down, which is a good eco round for Navi, because they managed to get two kills on Cold and Taco. So moving on to the next round, as you can see, the Guardian again has his AWP. Both teams have a pretty healthy buy, so let's see what LG decides to do now. Navi is known to go for defaults at the beginning of the round for many of their rounds on the T side, because they are simply really good at executing from that default, getting early picks or having some executes later on that you know win them a lot of rounds. So look at this, what happens now. Fallen throws the same smoke that he threw when he went in this position. So now he throws a smoke, throws a flash as well, and he's gonna basically do the same thing as he did in the first gun round again. But now Navi again is probably expecting this. So they throw two nades, do a lot of damage. They're throwing flashes as well. Seiz manages to get into this position before Fallen gets an angle on him, and they throw two flashes, and finally Seiz manages to you know get the kill on Fallen. So that's, I think they wanted to do the same thing in the first gun round. It just they messed up their execution there, and Fallen managed to get two kills. So now they're in an advantageous position, and Navi is one of the better teams at, you know, when they have this kind of a power play, if you want to call it, when they have a one-man advantage, they're pretty good at closing out rounds after that. So now they're just waiting around, because basically, you know, sometimes CTs feel pressured, they're a man down, so maybe they're gonna try and go for a refrag somewhere, maybe peek Ivy, or maybe Taco is going to push B apps or something like that. But for now, that's not happening. So Navi is speeding things up a little bit. Edward is going towards B. Seiz is still lurking in Ivy, wants to, you know, draw some attention to him later on when Navi is ultimately going to decide to go for a B execute. He fails a smoke here, it bounces off the edge, so doesn't do much for his team there. But as you can see, Taco is alone in this position. He just gets, you know, Guardian gets the entry kill on him. It's a difficult position for Taco there, even though, you know, he has a flash and a Molotov still, but, you know, his team is committed to the other bomb site. He's by himself. A Guardian is already holding that angle, so he gets an easy kill. Flamey gets another kill, and this is, as I said, a pretty straightforward round for Navi. They're going to get, I think, both kills in the end on the LG players. Yeah. So, again, as I said, it's not just about winning one round, it's about winning consecutive rounds. So an important round for both of the teams, although Navi will probably be able to rebuy even if they lose this. Again, Fallen has the AWP. You can see that Cold only has a CZ here. And this is why I think now we're going to see how this round unfolds. So Navi goes basically, you know, throws a smoke and a flash by Seiz. They try to cause some commotion on the outer bomb side, so they can go for a fast inner play to switch up the pace, which is good for Navi. You know, people also, a lot of people know for their slow, you know, about their slow pace, how they want to play. So this is a great call from them to maybe catch Taco off guard and Luminosity as well. So they go for that play. Taco spends his nades immediately, since his teammates are on the outer bomb site. He wants to buy time for the rotation. He gets a good kill on Seiz here through the edge of the smoke. Fallen is already back on the rotation. Taco, with some great individual play, gets two kills for his team. Fallen then steps in with the AWP. Even though right now it's a 3v3 situation, pretty decent for Navi, but this was an important kill from Fallen. The bomb is planted. Flamey doesn't get a kill on Fallen here, But right now it's a 3-1 and Fallen cleans up with two great AWP kills, and Luminosity wins this very important round. But now again, now with Dubai, but you can see here that LG now has two AWPs, and Guardian does have an AWP, but I think he exchanged with Flamie, and because of that, Flamie doesn't have any nades. Zeus is forced to go with the Tech 9 and nades. So you can see now what happens. LG probably knows Na'Vi bot anyway, so you have Fallen with one AWP going aggressively towards B halls, B apps, because the previous round Na'Vi went there with four players, so they probably made a call that they're not gonna do the same thing again, which is a good chance for Fallen to maybe get a entry kill and fall back. And you have ColdZera with the second AWP holding down Ivy. So in the meantime, Na'Vi doing their thing as usual, for getting the position in ladder, FNX close on the bomb train. ColdZera gets the kill on seized. Fallen is here, I think he misses a shot here, and they immediately fall back, which is a good call because they have the numbers advantage right now, and they have the double AWP, and now they can just, you know, play to those advantages, play it safe, and you know, get the rotations in later on. As you can see, Na'Vi is trying. They were trying to maybe get Guardian in a position where he could get another kill with the AWP, but Luminosity smoked off both ladder and mid. Zeus is towards the B side, holding for a push, and in the end, Na'Vi decides to go towards B again, with Flame is sticking a bit behind. So again, Taco is with Fallen watching the upper slope for him. Higher, Taco is again the guy watching lower here. So pretty important player for his team. But you can see that both Taco and Fallen are on point. They get the all important kills. And right now, Zeus is the only one left with the AWP, and he's going to save it for the next round. So here, basically, he will drop it to Guardian. Guardian is the only player who will buy armor, because if he is dropped an AWP, he can as well just buy some armor. Other players have only pistols, so they decide to go for B immediately again. So Taco has a lot of work to do yet again, but he's been pretty on point on this B side so far. As you can see, he gets another kill, an assist. His teammates are already on the rotate, and Na'Vi does get the plant, which is good for them, good for their money situation. They also get a lot of kills here. Seized, I think, got a triple kill by, you know, sneaking around through the trains, getting some close range battles with the Tech 9. The round is pretty much secured for LG. He's just wanted to try and get another kill, so this was pretty important. So 6-4 for Luminosity after Na'Vi got after Na'Vi had a 3-0 lead, and you know, considering how confident and how good Na'Vi is on T side train, with Guardian famously in an interview saying that they think they can, you know, get 10 rounds on their T side without much trouble. This is so far a great showing from Luminosity, and you can see another gun round, and again Luminosity goes for the aggressive Ivy push with the AWP to try and get the entry kill. Na'Vi is putting Edward in a forward position early to try and, you know, get an early kill on a player who might try to get up on the train, or who is somewhere around here where Edward might get a frag. So ColdZera again throws a smoke, goes aggressively, managed to get a kill before the flash pops from Seized. Na'Vi goes for a fast outer rush, but they pretty much get demolished by the double AWP setup from Cold and Fallen. So yeah, pretty straightforward round from LG. Not much to talk about, and this is where Na'Vi, you know, takes a timeout, and they go for another eco round, just buy a couple of pistols, smokes, flashes. This is what we call a quasi buy, where you just buy some pistols and grenades. You will still have enough money to buy if you lose the round, but you might get a plant, or you know, maybe even get lucky a bit and win the round. So what we have here is Navi wants to go for smokes on the outer bomb site, on the A bomb site. They wanna basically they're going for the plant. That's their main goal in this round. Just plant the bomb, maybe get a couple of kills, pressure the city's economy if you can. So here it's a this is a bit of a blunder by FNX here. Now he maybe had bad timing, maybe he was expecting a I don't know a flash, although I don't know where it could come from. So he turns his back towards the ladder room and Guardian gets a free kill here. And now you have look at the smokes. So these are all the areas that are smoked off. I don't know, I think that for some reason a smoke was here earlier. It was by Guardian, but then he rotated all the way towards ladder to come out here. So maybe it was some miscommunication from the Navi side, because this is, you know, as you can see, Fallen is right there. He can get a couple of kills from that position maybe. But Edward, I think, bunny hops or jumps over. He doesn't get killed by Fallen. Now they have control of the site. And seeing as, you know, Luminosity has the double AWP setup, they're smoked off. There's basically nothing they can do right now. They can't push through the smoke, you know, with flash in. If they had a rifle, maybe they could do that. So basically they need to, you know, leave the plant for the T's. Edward pushes through, gets good timing on Fur, gets a double kill there. Flamey as well manages to get a kill on Fallen, and just like that the round falls apart from Luminosity, and now we will win a really important round for them, as we will see later on. Cold Zera will get picked off here, and this is a great round for Navi to win. And right now again you can see that CTs are also a bit pressured in their buy. Cold dropped an AWP for Fallen, because in that round we saw before, Seized gets three kills when they were eco round on B. So they kept pressuring the city's economy. And you will see that I don't think Navi expected the LG to have an AWP here. And again, an important round. Money situation is tight. LG goes for another, you know, mix things up again. Fallen is gonna boost on Cold Zera here, and again you can see Navi throwing flashes, grenades. They're expecting maybe a push again. Navi now has two AWPs on Guardian and Seized. They're again in a sort of a default setup. They got early control of B hall, so now Navi was waiting for the smoke to clear. Now they're gonna slowly push towards Ivy, but they're not expecting this boost, and I don't think they were expecting the AWP as well. So they will get LG will get the early kill here. Maybe they heard Flamey as well. Fallen throws a great pop flash for Cold. Cold gets another kill, and again same as in the first gun round, with some good aggression and a good setup towards Ivy, LG is in another 5v3 situation, and the Navi is pretty much forced to try and do something towards the B side because they have no map control anywhere else. Taco gets another two kills. Edward is left alone in a 1v5. He's gonna try and save, and he did manage to save in the end. So Navi decide to go for a force buy again, since Edward saved and they have money for an AWP on Guardian. And now they go for a fake outer rush. They throw a lot of smokes here, flashes. You know, they want to keep the four players on B, so that Taco is the only player, the four players on A, I'm sorry, and so that Taco is the only player left on B, so they can get the trades on with him. And you can see how Taco is probably getting the call, smokes outside, flashes and so on. So you can see how he reacts. He starts throwing all of his nades basically to buy time if it is a fake, because they're probably calling that so far no one went out. So he throws a Molotov, a nade, he throws a flash as well. So at this point Luminosity should be aware that this was indeed an A fake, and I think that at this point FNX or Fur should probably be on their way towards the B side, because Taco right now is pretty much doing his job. He did some initial damage, as you can see with his nades. He is buying time for his... Oops, this is not good. Wait. Sorry about that one. Okay, here we are. So he bought time for his team, throws a smoke, a flash, and right now he's just trying to buy even more time But by the time Fur gets here, it's already too late for LG, because now you already got their position. It's not just the fact that they got the two kills here and here, it's the fact that they had enough time to plant the bomb, and that Guardian, for example, had enough time to fall back to the B apps. Because if we had, a couple of LG players already here, maybe, he wouldn't be able just to go up the ladder and fall back. He would have to first duel with those players, and it would have been much more difficult for Na'Vi in that case. So now they have the plant, they have Guardian in a good position, they have a Molotov here, also buying more time for them, and LG is gonna try and go for the retake. Initially here, Guardian gets the kill on Fallen, and Na'Vi will close this round out in a 2v1 situation. I think Zeus is gonna be in a 1v1, but he has the time advantage as well, so he just plays it really well in 1v1, saves the op, and that's it. So last round of the half, scrappy buy for LG here. As you can see, they have a CZ, 3 Mag 7s, and an M4. So again, when you have a weak buy or on a sketchy buy like this, you wanna try and make a play, because if you just stick around, you're not gonna be able to do much. Taco pushes initially here, gets traded 1 for 1, and FNX will also try to push up ladder. Fur is in a good position here. He manages to get two kills, which is great play by him. He ultimately gets traded, and now it's gonna be Seized. Makes a good call, watches the flank, gets a kill, but he doesn't expect Fallen as well to go from behind, and Fallen will be the player here who will get the last two kills, and it's gonna end 9-6 for Luminosity after losing a pistol round, so being down 3-0, and after losing basically an anti-eco round as well. So Na'Vi only won two gun rounds, if you may say, in this half, which is a great result for Luminosity against a team like Na'Vi. So moving on to the second pistol round, you can see that the buy from LG, they have a small grenade and a Molotov on FNX. Fallen has a P250 and a flash. I'm not sure why, if he bought something. No, he only bought a P250 and a flash, so he was supposed to have money. I think he maybe messed up and bought a decoy, and maybe he was supposed to buy a smoke, which is rather likely, seeing as they're gonna go for a B execute here. Now they're waiting just for some push initially from Na'Vi and so on, and ultimately they are going to go for that inner bomb site. They're just gonna. Now this is why I thought that they want to throw a smoke here and just run out, trade with a player if someone's close with a CZ or 5-7. What they decide to do is just jump down, flash, and battle with Seized here, and unfortunately call zero team kills Fur, but they're not quick enough to get to the bomb site. Na'Vi is already rotating because there's not a lot of time either. They get the good entry kills. Luminosity manages to plant, but Na'Vi just overwhelms them, and they get an easy round in the end for them. So Na'Vi wins the second pistol round as well. What's important here to note is that Luminosity planted the bomb, but they actually went for an eco here. I think someone, maybe FNX, just dropped the scout for Fallen to maybe try and get a free kill here and there. So this is also going to be a pretty straightforward round for Na'Vi. As you can see, they don't lose a single player, which is great from them. And now I was surprised by this, but I was positively surprised from LG. So they don't buy up in the third round either, after getting a plant in the first round. So they had around 4,000, something like that, but they decided that they needed more than that. They wanted an AWP on Fallen, they wanted to have all of their grenades, so they just buy a couple of pistols. Again, FNX gets a good kill on Seized, And in the end, I mean, it's gonna be Flamie gets 4 kills in the B apps, and they only lose one gun on seized. And I think that Guardian will drop in the M4, yeah, and buy the AK, buy the AWP for himself. So the first gun round, as you can see, because of the double eco, LG have all of their resources pretty much. They go for a similar default as Navi goes for. Navi may be expecting, you know, they throw three smokes immediately, one towards B from Flamie and two on ladder and mid. So what's important here, and throughout this half, throughout their T side, LG really fights for that Ivy control. They really want to get control of Ivy and pressure the CTs, so they can't feel as comfortable, you know, moving around maybe this area and so on. If they don't have Ivy control, they can get shot in the back and so on. So that's what they do in this round as well. They try to, you know, chase Guardian away with nades, smokes, flashes, everything, and they managed to do that. So now you can see that Edward is forced to come closer towards the ladder room because of that. Although Guardian is just rotating here, Zeus is on the 5 train, so you can see Edward pop flashing himself in because he's not sure if he will be able to get shot in the back or whatever. But Fur was already on the other side and he gets a free kill there. Another smoke for Ivy to keep pressuring it. So now you have Navi rotating seized as well to the other bomb site. Flame is left alone without any resources. They only have two flashes and the Molotov. They threw a smoke here so Zeus can be maybe more aggressive towards mid, but LG is playing it pretty safe at this point, and Zeus gets a bit, he's maybe unaware that his smoke has cleared here at this point, so Fur gets another free kill onto him. And right now they're just gonna swarm the outer bomb site and get the trades with Seized and Guardian, who are the remaining two players on the outer bomb site. Flame is, I mean, pushing B, but there's nothing he can do at this point. He gets a kill on Fur. He's gonna try and save the AK, and he was successful at it in the end, which was kind of important. I mean, it's always good to save a gun, and we'll see how much that will mean throughout this half for Navi. So Navi force buys, I mean force buys, they get a pretty healthy buy, three of the players with all of their nades, Guardian with the AWP, Flamie has only a flash though. So again, you can see Luminosity going for that early Ivy pressure. They throw a smoke here as well for Fallen to maybe, so maybe he can try and get a pick with the AWP. Guardian again gets naded down. He loses 30 HP here, and Fallen now goes back to Ivy to maybe get a pick there. Fur and Cold are holding their position so far still. You can see again Navi throwing a pop flash for Edward to get some map control here because they're pressured towards Ivy. And again, smokes, Molotovs, everything. You can see now Fallen is being more aggressive because he wants to go for a duel. Guardian is coming back. You can see that how other players are forced to move from Navi. Zeus is forced to play all the way aggressive here. Flame is forced to hide maybe a bit here. Edward is towards the ladder room, and Guardian was all the way here. Now he pushed up to watch the angle here. They're gonna exchange tags, him and Fallen, and now it's, there's some great individual play from Flamie getting two really important kills. And maybe LG got a bit, you know, overextended here because, okay, they're going, they want to try and find picks, and that's okay if you stay maybe in this area and just hold angles like this, right, and wait for the CTs to push or something like that. But they're gonna walk out here, and at that point you're really committed. I mean, and look at where the other players are. Fur and Cold are, they have no control of ladder room, so they can just run out here and trade with someone inside who is maybe, or a player who is, I don't know, somewhere around here shooting them in the back. FNX is all the way back as well, so you can see that right now Flamie will get these two kills as we just saw, but there will be no room for LG to react. anywhere else. I mean, they push towards B because that's the only thing they can do. But Na'Vi is, of course, aware of that. Sees he's, you know, just staying alive, buying time. He gets the kill on Cold, and again, it's now a pretty straightforward round from Na'Vi. And Flamie is had a great round here, but as we will see, he will have a lot of great individual plays, and he will be one of the key players for Na'Vi in this particular game. So in the end, FNX kills Flamie, but Seize manages to trade that kill. So again, as we mentioned, an important round for Na'Vi. They have two AWPs now in this round. So right now, LG go for their outer rush here, basically, which is something they're really good at. It's one of their bread and butter strats. You can see all the smokes, flashes, molotovs throwing around, falling around. Cole is the player in quad. He gets the early kill on Edward. This is the second round that Edward kind of messes up. I mean, you know, we had the first gun round where he pushed a ladder that didn't work out for him, and now he gets entry killed by Cold as well. So he's been struggling so far in that outer bombsite, and right now, because of all the smokes, LG is just holding positions, waiting for someone from Na'Vi to overextend. You can see that Fur only has a deagle, so this is a really important round for LG to win. Otherwise, they would have to go for an eco round. Taco is hiding here, so Guardian gets no info. Right now, they're maybe thinking that LG is going back towards B. That's why they have two players in B site. So still, just a safe play from LG. Just the waiting game is going on pretty much. Fallen decides to rotate towards the ladder room outside mid because he couldn't find a pick there. And now they're gonna decide to, you know, swarm that outer bomb site and rely on Fallen to get those picks. And it's gonna be, you know, Zeus a bit careless here, gets killed from Fallen towards the ladder room, and that's the go sign for Luminosity. Taco pushes Ivy, he knows that it's clear at that point, and they just, you know, overwhelm Guardian, who gets killed, and Flamie and Seize are forced to try and save the guns at this time, which is what they'll manage to do. And Guardian has, again, he has the AWP, so you can see that right now, every round that Na'Vi, you know, Na'Vi didn't have to eco a single round still, so this is a force buy, Edward only with a CZ, so they send Seize alone towards the B site, and I think that Luminosity are aware of this. They're aware that probably they're gonna have one AWP, maybe even two, but that they're not gonna have a full buy. That Na'Vi is gonna, in order, if they have an AWP or two, they're gonna have to have a FAMAS or a Mag 7 or a pistol or something like that. So what they decide to do is basically just throw some stuff outside and go basically for a quick B push or a contact play or something like that. So Seize is basically the key player for this round. It all depends if he hits his shot or not. He misses a shot, great entry from Taco, and basically that alone gives control of the inner bomb site for Luminosity. And looking at the resources that Na'Vi has and the weaponry, they can only fall back and try to get a couple of exit kills, as you can see, and just wait for the next round, which is exactly what happens. They save all of those weapons, so again, they decide to buy because they saved four Kevlars and so on. Another full round for Na'Vi, and again, Luminosity is aware that Na'Vi has an AWP at least on Guardian and so on. The problem is, you have to realize, guys, these rounds are extremely tricky for the T side to call against them, because you know that there is an AWP, but you're not sure where it is. You can see in this round, Guardian decides to push Ivy, so if you just go for a default, he can get, you know, an early kill here, then he can move around and so on. If you go for maybe a delayed execute, play it like a gun round, I mean, it is a good idea, but again, you can have some players here, maybe with a CZ or a Mag 7, close range and get a couple of kills. So in my opinion, what you would want to do is go somewhere as a unit, brute force your way in, make it so that the opper, if he misses one shot or even if he gets a kill, there's gonna be someone there who can trade with him, as we saw in the previous round from Seize. He missed that, he had that chance, he misses the shot, immediately he gets killed by Taco, and basically that wins the round from Luminosity at that point. And here they go for an outer fake with a lot of smokes, flashes. So this is something they did a couple of rounds before, so they just do a fake of that, you know, expecting Navi to react to it and have four players outside and spend a lot of time on the outer bomb site. Now this is a mistake from Flame. I don't know if he tried to push or he just wanted to be closer to the smoke, but again, Taco getting a great entry kill. And basically we see the same thing happen, only with different equipment and slightly different execution from the Luminosity side. So great round from them. Guardian gets another kill, and from this point on, again, Navi just tries to save. Guardian will save the AWP. They're getting a couple of kills here on Luminosity players as well. And Zeus, most importantly, got a kill on Fallen here, from here, and he managed to pick up the AWP. So right now Navi has two AWPs, so what do? Again, they decide to buy, which you can't really hold against them. I mean, if you already have two AWPs on a map like Train on the city side, why not try and, you know, full buy all the way? I mean, so we can see they decide to send their AWPs on two different sides. And Guardian here, as you can see, he throws the smoke intentionally to maybe make Luminosity think that there's a rifle here. So, you know, maybe they don't expect him here. Seize decides to go for the higher push as well. And Guardian gets a sick shot. This is a sick shot here on Taco. And Seize doesn't get flashed by this and gets another kill on Cold. And, you know, this is a... You can see how things change. Compare the previous two rounds where Seized was on the inner bomb site with the AWP and when Guardian was pushing Ivy. So both of those times Luminosity went as a group. They went towards the inner bomb site. They brute forced their way in. Okay, granted, they got the entry kill, so they didn't even lose a single man. So it looked pretty easy for them. But now they go back to their default, you know, and they get picked out. So from this point on, there's not much they can do, honestly. I mean, Fallen gets a good pick here on Guardian, but as we will see, again, Navi will be able to close this round out. Although, again, Edward dies here, struggling on the outer bomb site, but Seize steps in, Zeus as well, with good trade kills, and Fallen is left alone in a 1v3, makes it a 1v2, and then gets, I think, killed by Seize in the end, right? So a triple kill by Seize, great round from him. So, again, really important round, because Navi just won a round after losing consecutive rounds, only two players left alive, so this is basically a must-win round for Navi, otherwise their money situation will be just hideous. Luminosity has a pretty healthy buy still, and they go again for their bread and butter, the outer bombsite rush. You can see how Cold Zera is already, you know, pretty far up. Again, Zeus and Edward can't hold them off. They Luminosity gets the trade kills. Guardian is all the way back. Seize is on low HP. He's gonna get killed by Fallen. Again, another great kill by Fallen towards Flamey. And Guardian is forced again, basically, to save. He tried initially to get a kill. It didn't work out. So he goes again to save. He gets the kill on Fallen. So who I think picked up the AWP from Seize. But again, guys, Guardian saves the AWP. So this is, I think, the third or fourth round that he, you know, manages to save this gun. And Luminosity doesn't have an AWP because Fallen was chasing Guardian, and they have 5 AKs. Basically, and all of the Navi players have pistols only. So again, they go, they send Cold Zira outside. Guardian is alone towards the inner bomb site with the AWP. Excuse me. But now they're basically, you know, moving around. They're sending Edward. Inner Guardian is going towards the other bomb site. Cold is alone here. He's unsure, you know, where the CT players might be as well. He's trying to get some info for his team while his team is setting up for a B execute with smokes. And this is a good call. As I said, you want to group up when you know that they have an op and a scrappy buy, but the timing is bad for Cold Zira to die, because Guardian gets that kill. He realizes that Cold is probably the only guy there just lurking, and he gets back to B site in time to react. And Guardian right now gets some, you know, pretty amazing shots in. So this is a mid-air shot on Taco as well. Now their players are already rotating. They're getting close range with the pistols. And Flamey got his hands on the AK from Cold Zira as well. Gets two important kills himself, and Guardian will finish the round off. So that's how that one gun, how one AWP that you saved, of course, in the hands of a player like Guardian, how it can turn the tides of a round. And as we will see the game as well, him in combination with some great kills from Flamey, who really stepped up in the second half, you know, gave Navi basically another life in this game. And at this point, Luminosity, considering how they chased around Navi and their economy was pressured, now they have to basically go for an eco round. They go again for the outer bomb site, but now they don't have the armor, they don't have the resources either. They FNX get some great kills with the Deagle here. It is a 3v3 situation at a point, but you can see again Flame is stepping up with some great kills, and this will end up maybe even in a, I'm not sure, maybe even in a 1v1. So it will get scary for Navi at some point, because at this, you know, they have no idea where Cold Zira was. Well, he was rotating. He manages to get to the inner bomb site and plant the bomb, but you know, Zeus, this is the part where he falls down and kills himself. And Flame is actually one v one with not a lot of HP, but he, you know, manages to burn Cold Zira with that incendiary. So in the end, a pretty scary round for Navi, probably more scary than it was supposed to be, because they were in a 3v1 against Cold, but they win it in the end, even though their money situation is still, you know, being pressured. So LG are on a buy round. I think Fallen and Fur exchange guns again. Fallen will have the AWP. Oh, right now it's paused. I think Luminosity called the pause here. So let's just speed it up. Yeah, here it is. So as you can see here, Navi, again, important round, 14-13. You know, it was a close round for them, so they decide to switch things up now. Zeus is going to go for the aggressive push towards Ivy after a pop flash, gets the kill on Taco, gets traded by FNX, but still does some damage. You can see that on the other side, Seized and Flamey are going for an inner push, and Seized could have been punished here real bad by Fur, but Fur, unfortunately for LG, doesn't, you know, win the duel here. Seize gets the kill. Guardian got another kill on outer bomb site, and they do get the kill on Seize, but they have no idea that Flame is here as well, and this is the really important kill. And also Guardian decides to push Ivy again and gets good timing on Cold Zira. So again, aggression on the CT side paid off, and right now LG are forced to go for an eco round, basically, while Navi has, you know, all of their resources. So they just buy a couple of pistols and grenades and so on. And this is something that's, you know, in my mind, maybe a bit questionable. Zeus goes for the same thing again, but now, you know, throws a smoke and he gets punished by FNX. Now, I can understand this, that the first time they did it was in the round before, and you know, maybe they're, who's gonna expect that we do the same thing two rounds in a row, I can catch them off guard. But you should be aware that they didn't plant the bomb, their money situation is not as good, you know, that you have the advantage with resources, equipment and so on, and you know, it didn't pay off that time for him. While on the other hand, Edward manages to get the kill on Fur, who also tried to get a deagle kill. So right now, a 4v4 situation, which would usually be advantageous for the T's, but they are at a disadvantage in equipment, guns, and so on. So they keep, you know, trying to pressure Ivy, as LG likes to do. In other spots, they're just holding for a potential push from Navi. You can see they're gonna keep waiting and waiting, which forces basically Navi to go for two players towards the inner bomb site. Seized is watching just the exit from Navi, Ivy, and Guardian is, because of that, he's kind of forced to move to a different position. Now, this point, I kind of disagree with this particular spot, because now you basically have three players towards the B bomb site. You know, if Guardian misses a shot here, if he gets killed, then Seized is the only player, you know, that they have on the outer bomb site, basically, and Edward, who is on the rotate, but might be too late. So in the end, Luminosity decide to go for that outer push. Guardian peeks, misses a shot here, peeks again, gets a kill, but Fallen is already there to trade. Seized does not expect Taco here, he gets a good kill as well. Edward pushes, Fallen is in heaven right now, I mean up there. Edward gets that kill, but you know, FNX trades with him, and now it's a 1v1. And Flame at this point has no idea where Taco is, because Taco went out of Ivy, he could be anywhere, and Taco decides to peek, gets good timing on Flamey, and wins the 15th round for Luminosity, which was an eco round, so a devastating loss for Navi at this point. They were the ones having the upper hand and so on, and now they have a weak bye basically, and they have to try and save this map somehow. So you can see a mag 7 on Edward. He's gonna go ladder room. He just decides to try and go for a gamble, and he gets a kill, a miraculous kill on FNX, and they also go for this particular setup on the inner bomb side behind the smoke, where Seized will get killed, but they have no idea Flame is there, and he gets the first kill. Fallen doesn't turn around in time, Flame gets a double kill, he's aware that someone's behind him, gets a third kill, Taco gets two quick kills, but Guardian just shuts him down with a deagle, and again, a very quick round, but around that Navi manages to win with a scrape by. And the problem with here is that Luminosity wanted to go for that early B push, which meant that they have no map control nowhere else. So when FNX dies here, they feel forced to go towards the inner bomb site because they have no map control anywhere else. And then just, you know, unlucky for them that Flamey was there also. They weren't expecting that, and Flamey plays it really well and gets a triple kill, and we go to overtime. So, first round of overtime, now we go for their SCAR 20, which I don't know if I've ever seen them actually winning a round when they buy it. Flamey plays it from mid, maybe goes towards Heaven. Guardian tried to go for the early aggression towards Ivy again, but he got naded and flashed, so he decided against it. He falls back. Seized has an AWP as well towards the inner bomb side. So Luminosity go for their default setup, trying to get control of B apps, maybe later on of ladder room, pressuring Ivy as they like to do. And you will see Taco here sneaking his way through the smoke basically, and he got an entry kill on Zeus, which I'm not sure how that really happened, but you know, a great kill from him. We can see that both Cold and Taco are tagged and that they are low HP, so right now Luminosity have a man advantage, and they will decide here to go for a fake, for a beef fake, which is not a bad idea in itself in a 5v4. The problem is that they sent Fur, who has 100 HP, to do it, and the two of their players are already low. So Fur gets killed from Guardian, who is on top of the train, and he wasn't flashed. The flashes came in earlier, so he gets the kill there. They know it's a fake. They have Flamie all the way back with a Scar. Edward in a pretty powerful position here, close to the E box, and they have no more grenades left on their team. So you can see right now, Edward gets a kill on Cold, who was low HP. Flamie dies from the with the auto sniper again, but he tags FNX as well. Edward gets another great kill on Fallen, then on Taco, who was tagged, and again, and ultimately on FNX, who was also tagged from the Scar 20. So a great round from Edward, who was struggling in the regular time on the CT side. Now he's pretty focused. Gets a quad kill when his team was in a 4v5 position situation. So, you know, maybe a questionable. I wouldn't say that the call in itself was questionable to fake B. Maybe their execution was a bit lacking. The flashes came in too early, or Fur went in too late. And maybe it was better to send a player with low HP and, you know, have a full HP player on the outer bomb site. Maybe he would have been able to trade with Edward and so on. So same thing for Na'Vi, double AWP, a Scar as well. They go with four player because they're expecting an outer rush. They know it's the bread and butter of Luminosity, and now we will see the Taco is already pretty far up. Edward dies again, but Flamie gets a kill with a Scar 20. Fur gets a kill, and he's close here. Now he's pushing below heaven, and he's waiting for Flamie. Flamie will not show, and I don't know why, but Fur decides to pull out a nade, and at that point, Flamie peeks him and actually gets the kill. And this is a really, this is a, in this is probably the most important kill in this round, because if Fur gets this kill, Guardian is isolated all the way here. Sees this here, the bomb is all the way here. They can just go run. He can just plant the bomb. Fallen is they have Fallen with the AWP, and Fur also in a pretty good position at heaven. But instead of that, Fur dies. Flame is still alive, Guardian as well. The bomb can't make his way towards the bomb site as easy. Flame gets the kill on the bomb planter, but now Na'Vi just, I don't know what happened here, but they just give away two kills to Fallen, who doesn't have a who doesn't have the C4 on him, and suddenly sees he's in a 1v1 situation. He doesn't know where the bomb is, but he also knows where Fallen is. And now Seez decides to push here, and I can't really call him out for this because, you know, it's also a matter of preference. I mean, he's here. Fallen can be anywhere. He can be, you know, he can move to any part of the map. It's tricky for Seez because there's also a lot of time left. So he just decides to, you know, go for it, to hunt for him. He's unlucky that, you know, unlucky timing that when he checks this position, Fallen is hidden, so he turns around. You can see here, doesn't see Fallen, turns around, Fallen saw the edge of him, picks him and gets a kill. So now we lose a 3v1, which is, you know, in an overtime where you only have 3 rounds per half, it can be pretty detrimental for your team. But as we'll see moving forward, and also because they, you know, bought all of those weapons, Flamie only has an M4, Seez has a FAMAS. Fortunately, they have an AWP on Guardian. So again, LG going for their slow default setup, knowing that Na'Vi will not have a strong buy, and they were expecting, again, you see Fallen is here, they were expecting maybe Guardian to push Ivy again, so he's waiting for him there. They're just holding their positions, expecting a push. Still, Na'Vi are basically forced to have two players towards B because they have no map control. They have Zeus here close towards the Ivy area, and LG is slowly moving towards that B site where Na'Vi has a pretty decent setup here, although LG still have all of their resources. But right now you can see Zeus is he's pushing Ivy, he's getting that info. Edward is rotating and Guardian as well. So they're using their smokes, Molotov behind the site, grenades, flashes, but they have no one going on the upper, higher ramp or whatever. And that's pretty unfortunate for them, because these are probably the two strongest positions the CTs can hold if they're only supposed to hold lower ramp. So this is maybe the best setup Navi could have for this. So you can see Flamey drawing the attention towards him, then sees getting a kill, dies, and Flamey again. He just plays this angle so well from this position. He gets three kills. I'm not sure. I think maybe he gets the last one as well. Yeah, so again, Flamey with a quad kill, really stepping up for his team, and Navi does manage to win two rounds on their CT side. So, moving right now to second overtime, Navi, of course, back on the T side. As you can see, they decided to go straight towards the B-bomb site with all of their players. Guardian, the first guy in with the AWP, while Luminosity has the double AWP set up on the A-bomb site. And Taco again using his grenades early to buy time for the rotate to come in, which I'm not sure exactly why it's fur when they still have two AWPs on the outer bomb site. And now Navi goes for the B execute with all the smokes, flashes, and so on. Fur gets one kill, immediately traded with Seized. Taco gets another kill. He then gets the kill on Seized, but he's traded with Flamey. So great individual performance from Navi players to get the trades. Guardian gets an important kill here on Cold Zero, and now they're in a 3v2 situation. After plant, pretty good position for Navi. They know FNX is there, they know where both players are, so Guardian is here trying to get a kill. He will actually, you know, maybe he was a bit too aggressive, gets picked off by Fallen, leaving Zeus in a 1v2 situation. Fallen here missed an easy, I'm not sure what kind of a shot it was, if he was waiting for him, but he misses a shot here, and Zeus gets the kill on FNX, who was on the bomb. And ultimately, there's not a lot of time left at this point, and Zeus again wins another 1v1. He had a similar situation in their first half in regulation. So great clutch plays from the Navi captain. And so it's the following round. LG has money to buy, although you can see Taco only has a smoke. They don't have a lot of grenades left on them, so Fallen decides to go for the inner bomb side push. Cold Zero is close Ivy, Taco is close on the higher ramp as well. Navi falling back to their default setup again, throwing a lot of grenades here in case someone was there, securing that close position for Guardian to maybe push up. We can see that Fur pushed in towards mid, so they have, you know, decent positions considering their equipment, LG at this point. And they're slow, Navi is slowly, you know, falling back from that area. They threw a smoke here to try and limit the vision for the CTs. And here the timing will be, I think, a bit unlucky for Fur. He decides to push, he gets killed by Flamey, who was waiting for him, and also important to note how Edward sneaked his way through towards E-box. So he's calling right now that he has a pretty good position. Zeus gets picked out by Fallen, and right now they just decide to go towards the outer bomb site, relying on, they probably guess that since Taco is the guy who usually plays B bomb site, that, you know, they have two players towards the B bomb site. They decide to utilize Edward's position and go for the outer bomb site. They get info where FNX was, another kill from Flamey. And right now, Fallen has no idea that Edward can be here. Edward gets a free kill on Fallen. It's a 4v2. Cole gets a kill traded back, but Edward gets the trade kill, and it's a 3v1 situation for Navi. After plant, Navi win that round, of course, and in the end, they win the map 1960 now. While I was at the desk, I said that actually, I tweeted that Na'Vi didn't deserve to win this map, which was the wrong way to put it. Of course, they deserved it if they won it in the end. But take a look at, you know, the advantages that Na'Vi had. So Na'Vi won both pistol rounds, and they had a 14-14 score and the opposing team on an eco, but they, you know, drop it. Of course, Luminosity also lost an anti-eco round, but if you look at the second half of regulation time, Na'Vi didn't go for an eco round once. So every round in the second half, the CTs were buying Kevlar and whatever they could. And you know, that's why I think that out of the, you can see that out of the 16 rounds Luminosity won in the end, I think 14 of those were gun rounds. While Na'Vi did have, you know, the luxury of getting a few free rounds, you know, to get their money situation going and so on. I think this map was a great example of how you can switch things up on your CT side, also on the T side, how you can play against a mixed buy from the CTs where you know they had have an op, and also a great a couple of good examples of you know, switching up the pace, surprising your opponent, also just brute forcing your way in, utilizing some fakes, utilizing what you've done previously in the half to bait a reaction from your opponents. And this was an amazing match. Of course, it was really exciting. I'm gonna leave the VOD link and the demo link in the description as well. So let me know what you think about this type of a video, and if you would like to see more in the future. Thanks.